mind on. Let's take a dictionary based on the diet. Say, Chaudhry's up. Say, Gandhi's up. And inspiring personality, T.N. Trivedi, who has been always a catalyst for us to think more and more on safety. It is really a difficult task for me now, as all learned personalities, knowledgeable and experienced personality has expressed their views mostly on Trivedi Associates. I was expecting from them some more valuable guidance on today's topic, which is a topic, industrial safety, need of the hours. But they are always with us. Anytime we can have guidance from them. Much said about P.N. Trivedi and Associates, so I am not going to repeat anything about their activities and publications and all. But what I would like to express my views further, what is dignity has said about the safety. I am not going to the statutory requirements of clause number so and so and sub clause number so and so, or ASO guidelines, or TECFIDE guidelines, or IS 14489 guidelines and all. I would like to approach people with little emotional approach. You know, industrialization in Gujarat is going at a faster rate than it was in the past. And that is thanks to Narendra Modi, whose vision and mission, Vikas, has put us in a keen competition with industrialization. If you have heard his vibrant opening speech, he has touched industrial safety directly and indirectly both. He warned Indian industrialists, saying that now we'll have to compete with MNCs not only in the respect of cost and quality, but industrial safety too. That was his statement. I'm sure government departments, various departments connected with the industries, are putting their ample efforts to bring the awareness on safety to the industries, as well as implementing the statutory requirement most strictly. Thank you, sir. Now, in my opinion, absolutely my opinion, nothing to do with the government authorities, or I would not like to hurt anyone, but I would like to share my experience of 43 years now. It is said 41, but 43 years in the industry and safety related issues. Almost all small scale industries, to some extent medium scale and some large scale industries also, they structure their industrial safety or safety within the plant, keeping only factory act, age old factory act, IS 14489 guidelines or ASO guidelines, just for the approval of the industry, create the documents, start the plant, And till something happens, do not think beyond the box. That is the approach now. I would like to share one of my excellent experience and can say like a case study. When I was doing a safety audit of one of the industry where they were using 100 chlorine tunnels a day. So production manager was with me. We were taking the round for the safety. Beautiful shade, covered shade made for the chlorine cylinder storage. 10 tunnels was hooked with the header. Header was having a hood, so in case of any connection or cylinder starts leaking, there was a suction facility, and suck gases goes to caustic tower, and you know, neutralized gases goes out. That is the excellent facility provided as per the requirement of the rules and regulations. I asked the production manager, sir, let us start this blower. So he was fumbling, where is the switch? He called it shift engineer. Shift engineer quickly came. With great difficulty he found the switch. And sir, you want to start it? I said, yes, I want to start it. Facility provided and not utilized there, or dasera ke din ghoda nahi chalne wala hai, so what is the use of that? He said, sir, chalu karo? I said, yes, yes, start it. He pressed the button, blower did not stop. So he immediately went through an electrical substation, and after a few minutes he came back, I'm sorry, sir, this blower is not in operation since last 10 months. I told him, why, dear? Sir, baat chodo. Tell me the truth, sir. I am here just to help you. I don't consider me as auditor and going to hang you anywhere. Tell me the truth, sir. Sachu kausal. Aap lower na kaun. It is not of any use. I told him, why? Sir, whenever you are running this blower, it was not creating any suction in the hood. And this is known to my production manager and my owners also. That is. Now I request all that knowledgeable safety professionals sitting in front of dais, probably on the dais also. Think about situation wherever you are working. Think of a situation of your factory if you are an owner. And tell me honestly, if you stand on Gita, जो भी कहूंगा सच कहूंगा, सच के सिवा और कुछ नहीं कहूंगा. आर यू वर्किंग इन अ सेफ एरिया? इज योर कंडीशन इन द प्लांट इज एब्सोल्युटली सेफ? आर यू डूइंग अनसेफ एक्ट? आर योर पीपल डूइंग अनसेफ एक्ट? हैव यू कॉम्प्लाइड ऑल स्टैट्यूटरी रिक्वायरमेंट required for the factory, in reality, not on the paper. And I have been asking many times in many industries, where I do spot analysis of the industry. And you won't believe, more than 70% of the time, I am getting answer, sir, no. We are not in a safe condition in the plant, or the activities are not safe. And who prevents you to make it safe? Sir, it is not in our hand because money is not provided to make the area safe. But then I ask, if you do not ask them to do it, how it will be done? Sir, we have asked number of times, but nothing is getting done. Now think, if you are not aware about the situation in the plant and some accident happens, probably, you may not, but probably you can be pardoned. But right from bottom level to the owner, if it is known that in my plant or area or section wherever people are working is not safe and some accident happens, damaging to man, machinery and environment, maybe a fatal accident, killing one or few people, who is responsible for that? Who is responsible? We are all responsible for that. The thing is, if we know the conditions are not safe to work, if we know that people are not working in a safe environment and something happens, we are responsible because we have not taken care. I have seen a big board in the factories. Productivity overrides, safety overrides productivity. But that is all on the board. Inside story is secret. A big board that zero accident is our target. When I ask for their budget planning, zero budget given to the safety. When there is a financial crunch, first axing on safety department. अरे वो बाद में करो यार, पहले माल निकालो, पैसा कमाओ, बाद में सेफ्टी की बात करो. एंड इफ देर इज अ मैन पावर रिडक्शन, अरे वन सेफ्टी इंजीनियर विल डू, ही कैन डू मेनी अदर इंपॉर्टेंट जॉब ऑल्सो साइमल्टेनियसली. दिस इज द रियलिटी ऑफ ए स्मॉल स्केल एंड मीडियम स्केल इंडस्ट्री. Now, you think that in accident, whosoever, unfortunately, let us hope, pray God that nothing happens. But if somebody dies, think of he is your son, think of he is your brother. Do you have any right to make his wife husbandless, children fatherless, the only son father is sonless? Do we have right to give this kind of environment to the people working in the ministry? And that's why now time has come to rethink about our age-old safety, a factory act. Of course, a lot of modifications are coming, but think of integrated safety management. Now, if you have system in the organization for integrated management system, do it well. And that is the message and requirement for today, that come out from the old situation of the Factory Act and IS 14489, think beyond that, go for an integrated management system. And that is the need for the hour for the industrial safety in my message today. I would like to convey my sincere thanks to CN Trivedi and his entire group for giving me an opportunity to be with you and sharing my feeling, absolutely my feeling. Nobody should get hurt for that in this release and the authorities particularly. Trivedi, I will know very well, is absolutely a pious person, always ready to share his knowledge and experience with many. He always believes that sharing the knowledge, you learn. And that's why he goes on publishing the books, and the book published today, or open up today, is one of the finest books. I have seen that book before printing. It is absolutely an encyclopedia on CN. I congratulate CN sir and his entire family and group, because he considers his entire company as a family. And in the company also, he is known as Kaka. So with these few words, I congratulate Trivedi sir on this Silver Jubilee Day. A message from me, from my family, and all dignitaries and other participants in United States present here on their behalf. I congratulate and wish, not Silver Jubilee, but you continue to celebrate Golden Jubilee and Platinum Jubilee also. And we praise God.